It is great to see those that have stayed to the very last session. Yay. Really, really thankful for all of you and the great, great conference that we've had. We're going to close it out here in just a minute with a few remarks and some questions relative to a convention conference app that we've had this year. And so that's been kind of cool, and a number of you have utilized that. And so we're looking forward to talking with you about it. But we have a special treat. Last fall, we were honored to introduce a new celebrity partner to our work. As part of his sponsorship with Denny's, he has performed at churches in several southern cities, asking his fans to sign up to become mentors. And today, he is donating his time to give us a taste of what the congregations he performs for experience. So we're going to see a short video, and then Vashon Mitchell is going to come up and perform for us. So we are really, really thankful that he is here. So please enjoy the video with me.
Hi, I'm Vashon Mitchell. Every child should have the opportunity to reach their full potential. African-American boys are too often disproportionately represented among children who drop out of school.
Get involved in the juvenile justice system and become absentee fathers. They are also disproportionately represented among children waiting to be matched with Big Brothers, Big Sisters mentors. MentoringBrothers.org is a national platform that empowers black men to become a part of the solution to help African-American boys beat the odds. Our kids need us. If we as black men don't step up for them, they will find mentors in other places. A drug dealer on the corner or a member of a gang cannot teach our children the skills and values needed to be successful in life. In order for a boy to become a man, he must have a positive male role model in his life. Get involved. Every time you donate money or time, you can help change the life of a child for the better forever. For more information on how you can start something for a child in your community, go to BigBrothersBigSisters.org.
Well done.
Nobody great. Nobody great.
So just a handful of us had a chance to hear Vashon earlier, but many of us did not. And so he has graciously agreed to come back. And please join me in giving an enthusiastic Big Brothers, Big Sisters welcome to Vashon Mitchell.
Hey, I'm back. What's up, y'all? Y'all gotta wake up.
Searched all over, couldn't find nobody.
Come on.
I looked high and low, and I still couldn't find nobody. Yeah, there's nobody greater, nobody greater, nobody greater than you.
Thank you. You've been so great. Come on, clap for yourself. All right. So y'all weren't here earlier. So who wasn't here? Let me see your hand. Don't be mad. All right. That's all right. That's not bad. All right. So y'all can get a little juice and a banana, but breakfast is gone. I'm so glad to be a part of Brothers Mentoring, and we're going to do all we can. Not only myself, but I come with a team, have like 5 band members, almost 9 singers, and you know, management and publicists. We've already been putting out information as it relates to the program, and we're going to send the PSA out. We're just going to go full force within the next few months and almost a year to kind of get as many African-American male role models as we can in as many areas that we can to become bigs. And like I said earlier, I just relocated to the D.C. area, and I am also looking forward to becoming a part of the solution. So I got my application, and I'm about to sign up myself to be a big in the DMV area. Still trying to learn how to get around first, but I think I saw the office, and they speed lights is a little different. So I'm going to do a song. Y'all missed the 2 songs, so I need a favor for those who missed it. Vashon Mitchell is my name. It's on iTunes, Amazon.com, Walmart, wherever you buy your Christian music from. Go get it and listen to those 2 songs, Nobody Greater off my Triumphant CD, and Greatest Man I Know is the new song that's out right now and is doing well on the radio. I believe it's going to do just as well as Nobody Greater, but it talks about Jesus is the greatest man I know. And it's so funny how when I go out to speak to different groups, and especially young males, we talk about the attributes of God that we should carry: love, peace, joy, gentleness, kindness. So my thing is, why are we so mean? You know, because, you know, it's funny, you walk up to some of the men and be like, "Yo, what's up?" I was like, "Huh? Hello, how are you? What's going on?" So that's the song. So go get it. Help a brother out. I'm looking forward to moving around and doing what I can to be a part of the solution. So I'm going to do this song. You may not know it, you may know it, but all the songs, I ask you to clap, ask you to just wave your hand, tap your glass, something. We're going to have a little fun, then question and answer. Is that all right? Thank you. Let's rock this song out. That's all you need. If you clap, clap. If you can't clap, make some noise, say woo, whistle, do something. All right? Give them a little bit more volume so they can act like they're singing. The song says,
I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more.
If I had a choir, they would say,
I'm chasing after you,
no matter what,
no matter what I have to do,
'cause I need,
'cause
you,
I need
more,
you
more and more,
more and more.
You're clapping mighty good, you're clapping mighty good.
I'm chasing after you,
no matter what,
no matter what I have to do.
Cause I need you
more,
more and more.
So
I'm running after you with all I have. I'm
chasing after you,
no matter what I
have to do.
Cause
I need you,
I need you more and more, more and more. Here we go, sing
more.
What's up back there? We need you more. Some noise, let me hear you. Come on. I'm chasing after you. Can you make some noise? Say, whoa. I'm praising my way through just to be closer to you. Anybody here wanna? I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing after you.
Praising my way through.
I'm praising my way through.
I'm seeking you with all I have.
Just to be
I desire to be close to you.
To you.
I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing.
Now wake up, make some noise, holler, scream, do something. Come on. I'm chasing.
I'm chasing after you.
I'm praising my way through.
I'm praising my way through.
I gotta be close, I gotta be
closer to you.
So I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing.
Now you really gotta make some noise, 'cause the music about to get big. Let me hear you shout and clap, go on.
I'm chasing after.
That's good.
You.
And I'm praising my way through everything I'm going
praising
through.
Praising my way through.
I gotta be close, I gotta be
closer.
I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing after
my last time and I ran out of here. I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing after you.
Make some noise, big brothers, big sisters.
I'm praising my way through.
I've got to be closer.
Just to be closer to you.
I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing.
All right. Get ready for questions. Now, so lift your hands. Just lift them up. More and more. Can you say more and more?
Lift your hands. More and more.
Let me just say things more and more.
More and more.
All right. That's cool. Let me just say more and more. More and more.
More and more.
sound like y'all can sing? More and more.
More and more.
I'm needing you more.
More and more.
Oh, now we need you more.
More and more.
Thank you so much. Love you. Let's keep doing it big. All right. How about Mashawn Mitchell? So exciting that Denny's is part of Mashawn and his tour and a partner with us in Spartanburg, South Carolina. We're talking with Denny's about a national sponsorship and partnership as well. So more great things to follow there. Mashawn, thank you for being with us. You have an incredible gift and talent, and we appreciate your sharing it with us and being a champion for those to step out and become big brothers and big sisters, and especially getting our big brothers in to help us with these young men. Thank you, everybody, for a great week. I thank all of you, because our attendance and the energy that you brought with you is what really made this thing so exciting. We had a conference with 650 participants this year. Isn't that incredible? I mean, historically, we've seen conferences between about 450 and 550. Anything north of 600 is a big conference, and we were at 650, which is a true testimony of the network and the fact that we are reuniting as one brand and one mission, and boy, it's been a special week. Thank you. We want to thank Dave Ryan, our president of Big Brothers Big Sisters Colorado, for he and his team and their work this year and making this conference such a great success. Dave, thank you. And please come up here, Dave. Dave, I want you to come up here on behalf of the national staff, on behalf of the NLC, on behalf of the entire network, to you and your team for being such great host in the city of Denver, city of Mile High. We want to present to you our appreciation with gratitude and appreciation for hosting the 2013 National Conference. We thank you.
Oh, thank you very much. I'm honored to have been the host. It's been great having you all here. I'm thrilled that the number of comments I've heard about how much everyone has enjoyed Denver. I hope you all heeded the mayor's advice and spent lots of money. I also have to say it's the first time I've ever come up on a stage where they played Bruce Springsteen's Born to Run. I was thrilled about that. And if you'll indulge me for one moment, what's funny about that song, I was in the car, it was probably about 6 months ago with my kids, and that song came on. And my wife was with us, and she said, do you know who sings this song? And it's The Boss. Do you know who The Boss is? And my kids thought about it for a moment, and they said, Daddy? So that song always makes me feel good, but it's great to have you guys here. Have a safe trip back for sure, and come back to Denver anytime. Always happy to help you, so thank you.
And there goes the boss. My kids wouldn't answer that question that way. Not a chance. Thanks, Dave. Okay, we want to, we had, as I mentioned, the Business Technology Solutions team. Dave, this is important. This is really important. I understand our Business Solutions team will be donating the equipment from the AIM 360 booth to your agency. That includes the flat screen they use for demonstration. How about that? And we've been having an app, as I mentioned, with so many questions all week, and our first time, our national conference, to have an app for smartphones. And we had a total of how many? What was the number? No, just not questions, but the number of hits and uses on that app. It was a big, I think, it was a big number. Okay, it was a big number. So it really was, and we appreciate everybody using the app, and hopefully it'll be something that will continue to grow. But because I've already hit on a lot of the questions, and I've met with so many of you, and at the LAA dessert reception last night with the SMAA this morning and the MLAA this morning, but just one final chance. You get one final chance to get whatever you want. You know, if you've got any questions, if you've got a comment, if you've got something you'd like to say, please. We've got microphones that we're going to circulate around. We want to hear from you this morning before we leave and go grab our bags and either stay for the weekend or head back home. So anybody got anything they'd like to share together this morning?
Just to start, it was over 6,500 hits
there
that
go.
You guys had on
Thank
the
you.
App.
6,500.
So everybody was engaged.
I knew it was a big number.
Now, you guys, I've been hearing a whole lot of questions, so this is your chance to ask any question you want, and not just to Charles, but other members of the leadership team who might be here as well.
That's
so
right.
Go on and get it going.
Ask something about OJ. Ken. Here we go. Do we have a microphone for Ken? Thank you, Angela.
I may have missed the discussion about this, but on the OJ problem, I've heard a lot about dealing with OJ in terms of their partnership with us and appreciation of our work, but I haven't heard, at least in my understanding, about what we're doing with OIG.
So OIG is the Office of Inspector General, and some of you may not have any, you know, it's a government entity that actually has different groups that monitor different departments, justice, education, agriculture. So it's kind of like the IRS for the government, right? So you got the government, the IRS is for the public, and then you've got OIG, Office of Inspector General, for the government entities. And they've done their work. They've submitted a final report with recommendations, but they flipped it now to OJJDP to say, you guys, in partnership with Big Brothers Big Sisters, have 180 days to come back and close this out. The 180 days before we expect a response from you within 180 days. And so our focus is primarily with building those paths of corrective action with OJP, but OJP has experienced when working with OIG in terms of what they know OIG will accept and what they won't. And so it's a negotiation between the two, with this one saying, you come to us with your ideas and we'll let you know if that's acceptable and say we're willing to close this out. So that's the conversation. This one does the auditing. This one's the department that it is our partner in programs. Thanks, Ken. Yes, sir, Phil.
Charles, I started my job in New Hampshire about the same time that you started your job, and I left the conference last year in Washington very inspired, but I leave this conference even more inspired and also equipped with a toolkit that I actually plan to implement next week in my agency to build a high-performance culture. So it was just an absolutely inspiring conference for me, and I can't thank you enough.
Thank you. Thank you. Miss Cindy.
Hello.
Hello. Miss Cindy's on the NLC, one of our representatives, by the way, if you don't know that.
I'm on the Southwest representatives. I had two questions from agencies that are not here now.
Right.
About the financials yesterday.
Yep.
Under our revenue, our corporate donations had decreased tremendously from last year to this year.
Actually, they haven't. From the budget they did, but in terms of the actual numbers of corporations, mm-hmm. It's pretty flat.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because on the sheet, and I think that's something that there was a lot of misconception on the, because that wasn't explained. It was kind of just an overview.
Right.
So there were several people that had questions about why it went from like 10 to 2.
Yeah. It now on pass-through money. So
yeah. Okay.
There's a couple of different things going on here.
Okay.
So in terms of dollars coming from corporate partners, mm-hmm. the dollars were pretty even from 1 year to the next, right? Both years around $4 million. Now the budget that had been set forward last year was a budget of $7 million. I got to tell you that that budget was there was a lot of hope and not a lot of substance to it. And as we went back out and worked some of those opportunities, for example, and I'll give you one big one that was built into that $10 million, was $1.5 million with Humana. Well, Humana is a relationship that Jerry Swinton and her team, Kathy, and have built. And we flew into Louisville and said, hey, you know, I understand we're having conversations with Humana and I understand we've submitted a proposal. And Jerry gave me a look like, we have? Because I don't know anything about that. And then we went in to have a conversation, and there was no substance to that $1.5 million with Humana whatsoever. So the budget of $7 million ended up being $4 million, which was pretty close to what we did the year before. I mean, they were right on par. In fact, we might have been a few dollars ahead. So the actual dollars of corporate. Now, on the pass-through dollars, there was a drop-off of what went through to the agencies and this year versus last year. The primary amount of that, the difference, is the government money, which went out this year. So the government money went away. When you take the government money out, we actually had 2 times more money pass through that was non-governmental money this year. And that's the direction and path we're heading, and the budget for this year is $8 million. I hope that's helpful.
No, it is, and I think, and I would just like to ask, and this was something that was asked to me, is that that information is kind of disseminated out to the agency so they understand that, because there was a lot of questions around that.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Yep, thank you, Cindy.
Hi, Charles.
Yes. Hello.
The app was great. How do we get the documents off of those, the PowerPoint presentations? Will that be a link to that, to the website, to get that?
For the PowerPoint presentations?
Yes.
Okay. Who can help me with this question? PowerPoint presentations, how do we get our agencies to where they can download those? Anybody here from the team? Can they feel that? Hold on 1 second, Nancy. We're going to get you a mic.
You should be able to just click onto the session that you're interested in and click on the link, and it should take you directly to a web link where you'll be able to download all the materials.
And where will they, how do they get to that click?
It's on your app. You click My Sessions, you click on your specific session, and then there's a little link inside your session that clicks to the materials. If you're unable to download the app, we do have instructions. There are instructions in your folder when you pick them up at registration on what to do if you don't have an app, on how to get it just from your regular computer or your laptop. You can probably stop by the registration. John may hit me for this, but I know we have some of the forms that talk about how to get it if you don't have the app.
Great.
Okay.
Kelly, does that answer your question? Thank you. Okay. Yes. Chantel? The app will be available. Any of the meeting materials from any of the meetings that we have will be on the National Conference website for a year. And where do they find it on the website? Yeah.
It could be on the
TLO. On the TLO?
Charles.
Yes. I heard a voice. Okay, yeah, Charleston.
Conference.bbbs.org.
conference.bbbs.org. Thank you. Thank you, Chantel. Thank you, Charleston.
With the departure of Sandy Maskell in a few days, what's the plan for supporting agencies to roll out the standards over the next 5 months?
Okay, great question, Nicole. And Tricia or Beth or both? Or
Tricia. Yep. Tricia, you good?
Oh, okay. Craigwin, there you go.
Okay. So I'm Craigwin Parsons, because I don't know some of you. So one of the things to know is we are continuing the standards work. It will not end, and Sandy's been real clear about that with all of us as well. A couple of things that are happening, we are doing, the performance management team is doing standards and SDM implementation sessions out in the field. So many of you have state association meetings coming up over the next several months.
We're going out and we'll be doing work with you related to standards. We're also going to be doing some webinars for those of you that don't have state association meetings coming up with the same type of content. So kind of to get you comfortable thinking about what you need to do and where you need to go internally to kind of start working through more standards processes. The Q&A calls will continue. Our team will be leading those. So those calls will continue. If you have questions, standards@bbbs.org is still the appropriate email address. We're checking that inbox, making sure that your questions are being answered. You can email me if you have questions as well, or your program performance management team. We've been working very, very closely with Sandy for months to get really comfortable with the content. And one thing I want to share with you, we have the historical information about how the standards were created, how they were put in place, why certain things were changed, why certain standards that were proposed initially 2 years ago were modified. So I don't want you to feel like that information's lost. We have it and we'll continue to use that to help you.
Thank you, Kerrigan.
Hello, all the PSAs and videos that were played during the conference, how do we get those for recruitment purposes?
PSAs and videos that were used in the conference. Charleston, are you still in here? Kelly?
All of those PSAs are already on Agency Connection. And if those of you who don't go on Agency Connection, don't be afraid of it. Even I can use it, and I'm not the most technologically savvy person. You go on Agency Connection and you look under Marketing and Communications, and we have all of those tools there for you. And many of those are actually customizable, so that whereas they have the BBBSA, you know, .org, you can actually, or BBBS, excuse me, .org, you can customize those so that they have your local web address too. So, and then the video that we showed, the sizzle video that a lot of people liked when you walked in during the first general session, that sizzle video is on the right-hand side of the Big Brothers Big Sisters of America website now, and you can link to it, share it, steal it from YouTube, do whatever you want with it.
Thank you, Kelly. Nicole, did your question get completely answered before? Okay, good, thanks. Yes, ma'am.
Hi, I have a question more about the monies, and I understand what you're saying. I'm from Montana, by the way.
Yes.
About getting away from the government money, but getting more into the corporate partners.
Right.
And this might be a question more for the corporate partners, because what I know is I don't know, and that pretty much covers everything. And by the way, for Denver, thank you to your staff, because your staff is wonderful, by the way. I know it's a full staff offer. Comcast has been a long-term supporter, because I was here 5 years ago when it was in St. Louis, but
right.
How do you keep the corporate partners, because how do you keep those corporate partners going, and what's the strings tied to that? Because right. With the political arenas, there's always strings tied. Where's the corporate partner?
So you know, anytime you work with donors, in order to maximize their investment with you, you want to listen to them and find out what's most important to them, right? And Comcast is providing all of us with the support in the following ways. You know, advertising in every place that they have a footprint and market. Dollars that help us underwrite the cost that we incur with this event. And then they also give dollars, and the majority of their dollars go to 13 markets that are priority markets for them, where they have large concentrations of employees. Now, they are in a lot of markets. But where the 13 markets where they have a large concentration of employees, their dollars come in and are invested in those 13 markets in two ways. One, they invest them according to a Beyond School Walls program locally, which is a $30,000 per market investment, and additionally a $10,000 investment for a local board member's responsibility. So it's a total of $40,000 per market per year, which you can do the math on that. That's $520,000 annually from Comcast in those 13 markets. That money comes through Big Brothers Big Sisters of America and passes through to those markets as directed by our partner Comcast. So that is one example of one. Obviously, opportunities, there are a couple of different ways to build partnerships. You can build partnerships with, if you're not in one of those 13 markets, you can build partnerships with the local Comcast employees. which is beneficial in multiple ways. Obviously, it's volunteers. It's beneficial because they can come in and do Bowl for Kids' Sake for you or other local fundraising events. And if you do have some critical mass, hopefully it puts your market on the map for future expansion, because they are looking to continue to grow their relationship with us. And so I don't know what market 14 or 15 or 16 is going to be, but the greater relationship you have locally increases your chances for that opportunity to come to your market. So obviously we're trying to build partnerships with partners like that, and we're trying to build partnerships with partners like JCPenney, where the money is going to go back and be zipalized in the areas that they have stores where it was raised. So is that helpful?
It is helpful. And where I come from, I guess, because I watch Corporate Partners, I attend a film festival, and the Mercedes, it's major, just like Comcast is major, but somewhere down the line they go away, and I just wonder how we keep that process going. And you explained it as well as you could, actually.
Well, let me speak to that, because it's important. Again, I'm not trying to beat up what happened in the past. Enough already, right? I'm certainly tired of that. But the reality is that our partnership pipeline was very shallow. And the momentum that we had a year ago was we had a trend of Arby's and Rent-A-Center and UPS, and you know, the list went on, Edna McConnell Clark, of partners that had fallen off in that cycle. And so what I would tell you today is that the team has worked really, really hard, and that team is all of Big Brothers Big Sisters of America, all of you in the network, and specifically those that, you know, Kelly Williams is one that's interfacing with stewardship because of her key role in marketing communications. Lowell Perry, Charleston Edwards, myself, have worked really, really hard in connecting with those corporate partners to make sure that we're stewarding them well. And I'm proud to tell you, and you've heard from this conference, Comcast renewing for 3 years isn't an accident, right? I mean, they could have renewed for a year, or they could not have renewed at all. A renewal of 3 years is a statement that we really like what you guys are doing and what we're doing with you. Beiersdorf was here, and what did they say? Well, we've never been happier, and this is good for our business, and now we're using that as a test case with other corporations. Jack in the Box is really thrilled with where we are and what we're doing as an organization. I think the stewarding that we've had this last year has been really strong. It's vitally important nationally and locally that we continue to do that. In our breakout session, or when I met with the SMAA, one of our affiliates was sharing, and forgive me, I can't remember who it was. It was talking about how that she has met every week with her JCPenney stores. Who was that? Yes, stand up, be recognized.
Take in little purple cookies just to remind them who we are, and I'm asking them to participate in a 5-mile run that we have. And although he's not sure if he can do a financial support, he can raise teams for us who are going to raise funds for us, and their team members are going to run in the race.
And that's such a great example. Thank you for that. And the importance of not just the national stewardship but the local stewardship and the opportunity that can build with volunteers, additional funding for local events, and as I was on the phone this morning with Ed Martinez, the president of the UPS Foundation, and I shared this with the SMAA, what Ed said was, listen, the majority of our dollars are given away locally, and the opportunity for the local Big Brothers Big Sisters agencies to connect with local UPS staff and local UPS executives, that's the trigger for us. We invest in where our employees, what our employees care about, where they're involved, where there's an executive champion. So anything you can do to look at national partners, build those kind of local relationships, is going to come back and pay off in spades with campaigns nationally, but also with additional support through your local events and possibly additional gifts that can come from those executives through the foundations as a result of their participation.
I'm excited about where you're going, actually, and I'm one of those old dogs. I'm excited.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Other thoughts, questions? We're getting tired. So, the question is, with United Way Worldwide, is there anything going on with that? Candidly, you know, not a lot. I mean, it's we've got a cordial relationship, but I think what we found so far is that the engagement, you know, is best nationally. We're going to keep. Brian Gallagher has been wonderful for me personally. He's been a great mentor. He's been in his job for a number of years. I've met with him personally a couple of times. He's been, you know, advising, encouraging for me personally. Stacy Stewart is their new president in the last year for United Way of America. I've got calls into both of them right now. And we meet with them regularly. Can I extrapolate that into something right now with a campaign? Or I honestly cannot. Maybe there's an opportunity in the future to do that, but we don't have anything currently. Now, there was a discussion in the past about their push around mentoring, but I've heard a lot of comments that hasn't really taken root. You know, this national vision, there's some markets that have grabbed it and many that have not. So I know that's probably not the answer you want, but that's the truth. So we'll keep working trying to establish the United Way is an important partner to us. I know they are in local markets and local communities, and we'll keep having the conversations with them nationally with both Stacy and with Brian. Yes.
Hey, Charles. Hey,
hello,
can you
Michael.
Talk about your marketing plan? How will you build your marketing team? Because we can only serve more children if we recruit more volunteers.
Sure.
So can you address that? What's the 1 to 3 year plan for a solid recruitment yeah. plan, and how are you going to structure your marketing team?
Yeah, well, I'm going to let Kelly talk about that, but let me set the stage from some national vision on it. Clearly, we've already seen our commitment that we've begun a process and an ongoing annual commitment to starting an alumni networking campaign. That's an important step and piece of this. The other thing that I think is clear that I understand and I know is needed is we can't just go out and do a campaign that doesn't have a resource component to it, right? Because there are markets like yours that are just, you know, you're growing and things are good and you want to get that messaging out there. And there are other markets, you know, kind of a third are growing and a third are kind of stagnant and a third are in a negative decline, and the net of it all has been an annual decline for the last several years. So you're spot on right, Michael. We've got to build marketing and branding and messaging to recruit volunteers, and that's a national responsibility. But we've got to do that in concert with a resource campaign, or we risk all of you saying, boy, I'm getting hundreds of inquiries from volunteers and I don't have the money to make the matches and support the work. So, Kelly?
Yeah, that was good. But also, we need to do a better job. We're going to gather some of the NLC Marketing Committee after this meeting, in fact. But we do need to do a better job. Right now, we have communications calls, which, I mean, we have great participation, probably better participation than we have on any of the other network calls. But I think I really need to hear from people like you. Like, we need on the NLC marketing team to be able to make sure that we are addressing concerns. Because I do hear that, like, this year has really been a year where we have been operating, believe it or not, with no PR director. So it's been like, and we have been a lot more urgent than strategic, and we've been doing fine with that, but we know we can do a lot better. So in the building, and we will be building an entire new communications team, and it's a marketing and communications team. Integrated communications is where we're going. You know, we can't afford as a national nonprofit to have, we're just not as lofty to have a marketing department, and then you've got your communications department. It's all integrated. But quite frankly, that's happening in corporate America too, with social media and what's happened with just total urgent communications. We need to definitely be more integrated. We need to be more integrated with internal communications. I'm proud to say that, you know, the team, and it's a slim team at the national office, has done a fantastic job every week of making sure with the latest on that you guys are informed, that you know what's going on at the national office with our corporate partnerships. You know how you can leverage those corporate partnerships. So there are a lot of tools that aren't even being leveraged. There are some when we think about the usage on the latest on, people are opening it up now at least, and you guys are actually taking advantage. But we can still do a lot better. So you need to just know that we're accessible, and if you think that we're not doing something right, I am very open. I'm Kelly Williams, if you've never met me, and I'm very open to being criticized, to, you know, really doing better. And I know there are a lot of things we can do better at. So you need to be on the team, okay?
So Kelly is going to be working hard in the transition of this year with that that process of and I think Kelly and her team have done an exceptional job this year, and I really appreciate her hard work. So Michael, thanks for raising the question. It's got to be part of the plan, and resource development has got to be part of that plan too. We hope to build on our partnership with Clear Channel as well. Ken.
Yeah. Me again. From your last conversation call, you talked about Department of Labor, and certainly we know where we're at with the Department of Juvenile Justice.
Right.
Where are we? And you mentioned something about early childhood.
Yes.
Where are we with the Department of Ed? Because frankly, you know, we should be funded by them, and I know that they have gone to other modes of trying to help their education and the graduation rates.
Absolutely. So I'm very, very proud of our external relations team. Ken, thanks for the question. That has been working to diversify our sources of funds in Washington. For the last few years, we've kind of been pigeonholed in justice, and you know, that's good. We've got programs and opportunities and needs there as a partner. But the opportunity to be in Department of Labor, and we're excited about that in the middle of all of this, to get an award from them is very exciting. It's a modest award in the grand scheme of things. You know, it's $5 million over 3 years. So it's not a tremendous, in the grand scheme of things, it's not a tremendous amount of money, but it's a big precedent of a new partner with Department of Labor and a new opportunity to build and grow together. We have been having conversations with the Department of Ed, and I don't know if Olivia or Rich want to speak to that or not, but I'm delighted for them to do that, or I'm glad to talk about it either, too, Olivia. But no, go ahead, please.
Charles is spot on when he says the intentionality is for us to diversify across agencies and to find any opportunities that we can find where we fit. And for education, it's truly a matter of trying to work our way back in. Because as most of you know who had DOE grants and the school-based mentoring situation in the past, we fell victim to other poor mentoring. We got thrown into the same bucket with everybody else in that process, and so now it's a matter of trying to work our way back. Right now we have a proposal in front of DOE, which is an I-3 proposal, which is a partnership with Head Start. And most of you may have heard about it, but the idea is that we put a mentor in the life of a child who is leaving Head Start, and we keep that family engagement, because one of the exciting things about this partnership is that Head Start has a family engagement piece that is very strong, as do we. And so it's a natural partnership, and we've had a good time putting this project together, and we are shopping it all over corporate America and also wherever we can find a place. So if you have suggestions of entities who might have an interest in funding that approach, once we could move this past pilot phase, we think we have a lot of possibilities here. What sparked this is that Head Start got a report back from an analysis of their work, and it had been discovered that by third grade, kids had lost the advantage that they had had coming out of Head Start. And as a result of that, they were risking defunding or their funding going down considerably. And they needed a boost, and we needed a partner on the education side. Exciting also about that is that they are funded by Health and Human Services. And one of the things you want to keep in mind is, and excuse me if I'm talking too long, stop me, Charles, because I'm bad about this, is that a lot of these entities you hear about are funded by mandates from the government, and in this case, Head Start is one of those. And when you hear about Youth Build, that's another. I mean, there are entities that get direct funds by virtue of who they are or what they do. But in the process, we will form a partnership with Health and Human Services, and at the same time, Department of Education, and we're also shopping agriculture. And the pilot we were putting together with agriculture was just a little bit delayed, just a little bit behind timing. But the point is, there is intentionality about not finding ourselves in one place and depending on one source of funds at the federal government. And so we're excited about all of you partnering with us as we move through this process, because there's going to be fun stuff happening. And just keep your ears open, because we're being as creative as we possibly can. It's a creative team, and we're going to have a good time doing this.
Yeah, I'm really, really proud of the work that's being done there. We've made progress already. How many of you mentor kids in first, second, third grade? I'm guessing just about everybody. And the opportunity of mentoring kids in partnership with Head Start is an exciting collective social impact collaboration opportunity.
Just a comment about the power of the celebrity voice here at the conference, and for me, the sports voice, just because that touches with me. But along with Reunite Now, how does National or anybody in the room think is a good way to find more Darren Smiths?
Yes.
How do we find out these pro athletes who are great sports people, if we can find them, to find out that they were former Littles?
Yeah, you know, that's hopefully going to be part of our discovery with our alumni networking campaign. Because you know, there are a number. I'll give you an example of one. Darren Williams, the point guard for the Brooklyn Nets, former little brother, right? Now, I found that out by happenstance, because he came to a golf tournament, and I'm riding around with him in the golf cart, and he said, "You know, I used to be a little brother." No way. So I mean, they're out there, and they're in. I guarantee you, probably almost every market of the major sports markets, one of those professional athletes of those teams has probably had some connectivity to our organization in the past. So hopefully, as part of this whole discovery and relationships with those teams and those player reps and the Reunite Now campaign, we're going to discover more of that and invite them in and then give them a platform and a microphone and an opportunity to be a champion for us. So I agree with you. That's something we need to do more and more of. Miss Jerry, I'm sorry we didn't let you know about that $1.5 million proposal to Humana. Are you still mad at me about that?
I was never mad at you about that. Maybe prior people, but never you. First off, I just wanted to acknowledge publicly and thank the national staff that things have been very difficult the last couple of months in learning about the OJJDP funding freeze, but I have reached out to Mary Flores, Beth Morgan, Kelly Williams, and I have had a phone call back. I've talked to people like on Friday nights for an hour, just trying to figure out my own strategy and what to do. So I very much appreciate and wanted to publicly thank you for your accessibility and for your coaching through all of this, because it is what it is, and we need to move forward. And one of the things that I've learned from watching you, Charles, through all of this, that whether we all agree on strategies or whatever, that on the call, one of the things that you said is hope is not a strategy here, and that we needed to right the ship and balance our budgets, and that was painful. But at the same time, you've continued to be very positive and to move forward, to look at Mentor 2.0, to look at various ways to innovate. And so many of us left here in the room are CEOs, and I wondered if you could just take a minute and talk to us about that leadership mindset that you have of all the challenges that you've been faced with, but continuing to be positive and innovative.
Well, thank you, Jerry. I appreciate your positive leadership. It can be hard. It absolutely can be hard. Change is difficult, and difficult times, challenging times, are difficult. And all of us have to seek out what it is that can get us through. Some of us are people of prayer, and that's something that's very important for me. Others of us are people that we really draw energy from other colleagues and other positive people. And that's a good thing in terms of association, right? We do reflect those that we associate with. And if we associate with negative people, we're going to tend to be negative. And if we associate with positive people, we're going to tend to be more positive. And we always have to strike the balance because, energy and enthusiasm and hope doesn't pay the light bills, right? And so we do have to be realistic about that. But there is always a way to look at that glass half full or half empty. And our association with colleagues is an important part of that. Our encouragement of others. I want to thank you for your encouragement this year. Because so many of you have written me notes and said you're praying for me. And that matters to me. It means a lot to me. And I want to encourage you to do that with one another. And I know you do. And I've seen you do it. So our best years are ahead of us. They have to be. This brand is too relevant and too important for them not to be. And what we have is something worth fighting for and something that is meaningful and valuable. And to Michael's point, how we tell our story with marketing and media is really important. How we tell our story with partners from a stewardship perspective is really important. But it is about relationships. It's about relationships to help us bring resources. It's about relationships in terms of what we do with our mission and delivering it. How you stay positive and all of that, I'll be the first to say there are days that, I have my little pity parties. And my dad's not with me anymore, but I hear him in my ear. Charles, get up. Stop feeling sorry for yourself. And get going, And so thank you for your encouragement and for the great work that you're doing, because that really is inspiring. It's inspiring. And certainly what fuels how I try to look at that glass half full. So thank you.
Charles?
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's always great to go back and sharpen the saw and get ourselves all remotivated. And for those who have been around for a while, we know how important that is. One of the things that I thought was really great a couple of years ago, and want to know if we have any intention of getting into that space again, was what I learned when I attended the Grad Nation Summit. Mm-hmm. Would absolutely love to see us and the CEOs here have a larger exposure to going to that conference, and that is all about the education space.
Absolutely.
So do we have plans to getting back openly and visibly involved with Grad Nation, and what can we do to get more of us integrated into that process?
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you, Anna, for asking that. Unfortunately, I was not able to attend that this year personally because of some of the challenges we were working through. But I do plan to be there in the future. We did have staff there. We weren't as visible as at times in the past, and I think there is opportunity there. Anna is also, while I'm addressing her with that comment, somebody, I think, Jerry, to your point, Anna and her agency went through a really difficult period a couple years ago, and they've just been rocking it and coming out and doing great. And so that's another important piece of this, right? The perseverance, just chipping away and hammering and hammering and hammering, and you beat on that rock and it doesn't break, but eventually you may hit it the 100th time and it's going to break, and it's not that hammer that, not that swing that broke it. It was all 100 persistent swings that weakened that rock and moved you forward. So thanks for being a great example for us too. But thanks for the comment. America's, the grad nation is very much an important future conversation for us. Thank you. I want to recognize our national staff that have been involved with putting on this event. Would you stand, or those that are in the back, come forward that have been involved with putting on this national conference? Anybody from the national staff that's been involved with planning, working? Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Here comes Kelly. A lot of people did a lot of work. And they did it with a lot of passion and energy. In particular, I do want to thank Kelly and Charleston. I want to thank John Kulikowski. Jamie has moved on to another opportunity, but Jamie also was very involved. Marlene Olshan, Amy Valentine was a rock star, as she always is, and so many other hands that were involved in this. Our committee that put that on. Who is in here that was on the committee? Anybody from the agencies that was part of the committee putting the thoughts together? Thank you so very much. Great, 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 great work. Outstanding. And we would love for any of you that want to be part of the planning process next year, please let us know. Raise your hand if you want to be part of that planning process. We got a couple of volunteers. Yay. That's great. Lynn.
Charles, if I may. Dave Ryan.
Dave, yes.
Yeah. I also neglected to do this, and I really needed to. So we started when you mentioned at the beginning of the conference that you made this call to me and told me that we're having the national conference here. And the national conference staff, I can't imagine how they pulled off a conference like this in the midst of all the transition and the OJJDP stuff. We had biweekly conference calls where I was the guy struggling to keep up with them. And so I have to say, I appreciate that you thanked me for this, but most of the credit goes to the national staff. It's been a real pleasure working with them, and I really need to say that. So
thank you,
thank
Dave.
You, you guys.
Thank you, Dave. Thank you. And so Lynn West said she would. Laura Capello said she would. Thank you. And if others would like to, let us know. We start that process early. And because part of the process is you got to get feedback right away while it's still fresh in everybody's minds. What'd you think? What'd you like? What would we change? How can we make it better? And so we want to start that process early, and we really need you to be involved because this needs to fit you. And we've also asked for some additional input from our agencies about next year's regional conference. So next year's national conference is in Chicago. Be making your plans. And then we're going to have a regional conference, East and West Coast, and we'll be announcing those sometime in the near future. And we want feedback from you. We solicited that from our SMAA or MLAA about what you want. What are you looking for in those regional conferences? We know training. We know program support. But what are you looking for? Help us plan those effectively so we are providing you with what you want and need as we go back to regional conferences. So I think this is a good place to just say thank you. It's been a great, great several days together. Anna, yes? State Association meeting in July in Florida.
And Hutchinson Island, we actually have a direct, the
Secretary of Education is coming to address us, and so is Frank Brogan. So, and we do have standards and AIM 360 and some other national trainings that are going to go to the next level. So we will get the information out to someone. Registration's open. It only costs $35 to come. So we'd love to have you come out to the...
So if others are nearby and want to join in Florida, I was there with them last year. They do a great, great job. Thank you.
Thank Anna. You.
All right. Any other burning comments or closing remarks? Thank you for being part of Reunite Now.